I'm going to present some of the results that we reach in a project that is financed by Lombardy Regions, and it is Precision Pop. Is a system to support precision forestry in popular plantations. So we set up different things, and we use different types of remote sensing data, proximal and satellite data. So I would like, before to start, to say thank you to all the co-authors of this presentation that worked with me on these projects. Popular plantations are of great opportunity for climate change mitigation because they grow really fast and they have a very short rotation period, so they are able to stock carbon, dioxin, and also to provide ecosystem services related to the forest in Italy, but also in Europe. And they represent a really important aspect for forest economy in Europe, because about 5 million cubic meters per year were used in European country derived from popular plantations. So the monitoring of the state and the growth of these plantations is really important because this is also an economic aspect for the economic aspect related to the wood of popular plantation. So to monitor the state and the health of popular plantation, we need to increase the availability of systems that can give us complex information related to the popular plantation, especially related to the stress, because we need also to reduce the use, for example, of water and the irrigation system science with climate change. We have also problem related to water availability, also, for example, in Pianura Padana in Italy. But these problems are also the same in Spain, in France, or in Germany. So all European countries have more or less the same problem. So the project that we have with the CREA and the University of Florence, so we have three phase project, and I will give you some information more related to this phase two and phase three. In the first phase, we set up an automatic classification of popular plantation in the Pianura Padana. So using time series Sentinel-2 data, we are able each year with an semi-automatic approach using deep learning to classify popular plantation in order to give to the market the availability of forest plantation area each year. So we are able to classify popular plantation with 4 years, so since the class between 1 and 3 years are not detectable from Sentinel today. So each year we are able to have the map of popular plantation. On the base of this map, we set up an early warning system using ground UAV and Sentinel-2 data. And to do so, we set up in the second phase a calibration between Sentinel-2 data and the UAV imagery. We set up this project in all the Lombardy regions. However, we have some test area where we go to measure information in the field and to acquire data by drone to set up this kind of information. This is the three areas that are located in different provinces of the Regione Lombardia, and we acquired all the data related to the trees. So we calibrate all the trees and we estimate growing stock volume and crown volume on the basis of volumetric model developed by Chianucci at CREA in 2020. And then we acquired also digital cover photography in order to have information related to the lie of this plantation. We measure different clones and different plantation divided by different years. So we a small plantation and the one with 10 years that are at the end of the rotation period. Firstly, we study the correlation between UAV data that were acquired with a MicaSense camera with Red Edge and NIR. So we calibrate the data between here you have Sentinel and UAV data in order to understand the correlation between the bands acquired by satellite and the band acquired by UAV. This is, was really important because the, in the next step of the project, we will try to upscaling the model done by drones with the one that we can derive by Sentinel-2. The correlation that we find is really high, except for the blue band. And you can see that between the different study area, we have a different correlation. This is because we made different field campaign in different time of the year. So, so the Landsat, the Sentinel-2 images were acquired in different part of the vegetation periods. We have a height, very high correlation between vegetation index. Here you will find the green and DVI that is acquired by drone that is high correlated with the LI derived by digital photography and also the UAV green and DVI that is correlated with Bezier area. We found that with the drone could be possible to estimate and to model in all the plantation, not just in the block where we go through the measure, the leaf area index that is really important when there is a defoliation, and also the basal area that is a proxy of the growing stock, and the foliage cover that is really important also to monitor when there is some stress related to defoliation of some fungi. Then we use this data to set up in Google Earth Engine a early warning system where we test different types of vegetation index. We test NDVI, but if you see here from these images, you can see that there is not a lot of difference between the spectral trajectory of NDVI of control areas without stress that are the pink and the stressed plantation that are in blue. While other types of indexes, for example, NBR and green and DVI perform better to understand this information. We set up the index that we will use in the early warning system according to the some reference point where we have the exactly stress. So we have some stress from rugine and some stress from defoliation, some stress related to the water stress. So we set up this, this early warning system analyzing the spectral trajectories of this index. Then we set up some threshold on this index to to classify the polygon in stressed, maybe stressed and not stressed. Here you can see that there is a popular plantation in Pavia province, where in the late July, there was nothing happened and the system will return all the plantation in green because here from the spectral trajectory, you can see that the green and DVI is always higher than 0.75. If we analyze in the early warning system in the late August, so 13 August, with the available image, we can see that there is a drop of the spectral trajectory in the DVI, and we analyze a part of the plantation that was stressed. And here we register in the field with a field campaign that there was a defoliation in that area. So we give this information to the popular owner in order to go in the field and make some treatment that could help him to reduce the area of this defoliation. So then this system that is produced in Google Earth Engine go to download, we are able to download this data in a server and upload it in a very easy WebGIS platform where the popular plantation owners can see their polygon in different color, green, red, or yellow, on the base of the area that is stressed in their polygon. This polygon are the one that we detected with the automatic approach. So we are able to give this information in all the Regione Lombardia. And of course, we are working now to implement also the graph aspect in the WebGIS platform. One conclusion that we can draw is that for popular plantation, maybe NDVI, that is the most used index, is not the best one to monitor the stress. Since we test a lot of different indexes, and we found, for example, that green NDVI and MBR are better than green NDVI that is always used. So we decide to use these indexes because in our validation point, they work better. So I have finished. The tools will be available online soon. And you can use it if you want in the future.